powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
Glory be to God. This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad. You're welcome to this live transmitting broadcast, and today I want to share with us, trust God with what you have. What you have may not look like so much right now, may not look much right now, but if you can trust God with it, He can multiply it. You know, sometimes people say things like, what I have is not enough. It may not be enough, but God can multiply it. It may not be enough, but if you can trust God with what you have, expect uncommon manifestation. A lot of people are depressed and frustrated because they can't truly trust God with what they have. They felt that what they have is not enough for the vision, for the bill, or for the project. But you see, when we begin to trust God with what we have, He will open the door of multiplication. Now, Jesus had a vision to feed 5,000 people. They have been with Jesus for some days hearing the word of God, and they were hungry. And Jesus didn't want to let them go that way. Then He asked the disciple, what can we do about this situation? The Bible said, He Himself knowing what to do. And they said, there is a lad here with 5 loaves of bread and 2 small fishes. It doesn't look like much. But when faith is in it, multiplication will be made manifest. What you have may not look like much right now, but if you will trust God with it, you will come out of that situation. Sometimes we look at the situation and then we think that God is not faithful to keep His word. Our God is a faithful God. When we walk by faith, we open the door of uncommon blessing. When we walk by faith, God is able to exceed your expectation if you can trust Him with the situation. God is able to exceed your expectation. It doesn't matter how you feel right now about what is available. 5 loaves of bread and 2 small fishes doesn't look like what would take care of 5,000 people and more. But you see, when God is in it, it is enough. I want to say that again. I said, when God is in it, it is enough. The most important thing is to believe that God is your source, is to see God as your source, not just what you have. A lot of us keep looking at what we have. We keep looking at what we have. Then we're not looking at God. Because if you look at God, He will multiply what you have. And what you have may not be able to take care of this situation, but if you're walking by faith, what you have will multiply to become a provision for this vision. In 2 Kings chapter 4, the widow came to the man of God and said, my husband have died and my 2 sons were to be taken as slaves because we are in debt. And the man of God said, what do you want me to do and what do you have? You see, there is something about what you have that God can look at it and say, well, I'm going to bring increase on what you have. I'm going to multiply what you have. God will multiply what you have. He's also a God who can multiply, who can bring multiplication out of nothing. Maybe there is nothing right now. You don't have anything. You don't know how you're going to pay these debts. You don't know how you're going to handle this situation. But if you begin to trust God, if you begin to speak the word of God, If you begin to look up to God, then the depression will not be there. Then the anxiety will not be there. You begin to have hope that something amazing is going to break out. Like we shared some few hours ago in our Zoom church, we said heaven will be breaking loose on people this week. You know, a lot of people are used to hell breaking loose. You hear someone said hell is breaking loose. But when heaven begins to break loose, the impossible becomes possible. And there are people watching this broadcast right now. The Lord will have me say this to you. I will multiply what you have. And the man of God said to the widow, go and borrow vessels. 2 Kings chapter 4, if you read from verse 1 to 10. He said, go borrow vessels. In the natural, she may have said, well, we just borrowed some few months ago. We borrowed some things, and now my husband died and we're in debt. I don't want to borrow anymore. God will give you an instruction of what to do with what you have. I said, God will give you an instruction of what to do with what you have. Divine instruction is the key to unlocking supernatural victory. One of the ways we unlock supernatural victory is to receive divine instruction. So when God gives us an instruction, He has given us the foundation for our expectation, the foundation for the right action. So the man of God said to her, go and borrow vessels, walking by faith is the doorway to uncommon increase. Walking by faith. If you can trust God with what you have, there is no situation that will stop the manifestation of your vision. If you can trust God with what you have. You know, in John Gospel chapter 2, Jesus was invited to a wedding in Cana of Galilee. And Mary was also there and other disciples were there. And the people run out of wine. And Jesus came to Mary and said, well, I'd like you to help out in this situation. They have run out of wine. And when Mary said that to Jesus, Jesus said, my time have not come. Which suggests, I can't do this right now. I can't do this right now. But Mary did not mock Jesus. And Mary refused to worry. And Mary refused to be depressed or frustrated. You know what Mary did? Mary went to the people, to the servants, and said, whatsoever he said to you, do it. You see, it's important that we understand that limitations and opposition cannot shut down your faith if you choose to focus on God. Limitations and opposition cannot shut down your faith if you choose to trust God. If you choose to trust God, nothing can be impossible to you. Nothing can be impossible to your vision when you choose to trust God. You know what happened? And Jesus showed up a few minutes later and said to the people, fill the water pot. You see, this is how miracles happen. Miracles happen by faith. When we begin to walk by faith, when we trust God, when we believe God, amazing things begin to happen. Jesus said to them, fill the water pot. Jesus said to them, fill the water pot. When he said, fill the water pot, the people obeyed. And Jesus said, draw out. You see, there was something that was available. It was water. But if this water is going to turn into wine, this is why you should not be distracted by what you heard. You should lay hold of God's word. I said, you should not be distracted by what you heard. Whatever you heard in the natural, you should not be distracted by it. You should focus on the word God has given to you. The word God has given to you is the foundation for releasing your faith for miracles. The word you receive from God, that rhema word that God gave to you, it may look like what you have is not enough. It may look like what you have is not enough, but when you choose to trust God, when you choose to believe God, the impossible will be made visible. When you choose to trust that this situation considered to be an impossible situation will be made visible, you'll be amazed how God will turn what you considered impossible to be made possible. I heard this testimony yesterday. A preacher went, heard that the place was being sold, was going for sale. When he heard that the place was going for sale, so he decided to go buy it. Then he put an offer on it. And then another company came and offered more than the preacher. So the owners of the properties decided to sell the property to that business people. You know what happened? The preacher felt bad. He felt like, well, I've lost it. You know, sometimes before you see some miracles and some manifestation, it looked like you're in the deep. It looked like you're in the dark. It looked like everything is not happening right. It's not working right. In such situation, don't lose your eyes on God. Don't lose your focus on God. You just keep your focus on God. You continue to do the word. You continue to apply the word. You continue to believe the word. You continue to walk by faith. You continue to trust God. You know what happened? That business owner bought over that place and did some roof job, take care of the air conditioning, make the place look beautiful. And after many months later, ended up selling it for the same preacher. At the same price, the preacher was asking the owners to sell it. He has taken care of the roof. He has put in air condition everywhere and still sold it at the price the preacher offered many months back. Can I say this to you? It may look like you have just lost the battle. That is what it looks like. But when you walk by faith, what you see is victory. When you walk by faith, you see the impossibilities becoming possible. And I hear the Lord saying, what you have, I will multiply if you will trust me with what you have. What you have, I will multiply if you listen to my instruction. If you follow my instruction, if you follow what I'm telling you. Romans 8:14, it said, as many that are led by the Spirit of God, he said, they are the sons of God. The true sons of God listens to the leadership of the Spirit. And listening to the leadership of the Spirit is the foundation for unlocking uncommon success. Listening to the Holy Spirit is the key to being at the right place, at the right time, with the right people, doing the right things. So whatever is in your hands right now, you can trust God for a great future. You know, I like God because he can do anything if we choose to walk by faith. He can do anything when we choose to trust him. God can do anything when we choose to believe his word. And there are so many of us right now who may be going through some financial situations, some challenges right now in the natural, and it looks like nothing is going to work out. But I'm here to say to you that if you can trust God with what you have, expect uncommon miracles. If you can trust God with these 5 loaves of bread, if you can trust God with this jar of oil, with this water you have right now, it doesn't matter what you have right now in the natural. In 2 Kings chapter 4, the woman had a jar of oil, a pot of oil. In John Gospel chapter 2, for that miracle to happen, they only have water. In John Gospel chapter 6, it was only 5 loaves of bread and 2 small fishes. But whatever you have, our God is a miracle working God, because your faith becomes productive when your faith relies on God's ability. I want to say that again. I said, your faith becomes productive when your faith relies on God's ability. This is how faith becomes productive. When your faith is on God, like Jesus said, he said, have faith in God. It is actually faith in the ability of God. It is faith in who God is. It is faith in what God can do. It is faith in his goodness. Because when we have the revelation of the goodness of God, our faith becomes effective, productive. This is how we come into fruitful lifestyle, when we trust in the God, in God, in His goodness, and then our faith begins to make progress. You're watching this broadcast right now. It's time to trust God with what you have and expect a miracle. Expect opportunity. Expect preferential treatment. Expect supernatural increase. Expect the doors to open in right places. Expect the right atmosphere this season. Someone is watching this broadcast. I hear the Lord saying, stay out of depression by trusting me. Refuse to be depressed because of what you heard. He said, whose report do you believe? Are you believing the reports of your banker, or you're believing the reports of the people, or you're going to believe God's word to open the door of the miraculous? Because miracles happen when people believe God. I said, miracles happen when people believe God. One of the ways we come into the miraculous is when we believe God, irrespective of what we may be going through in the natural. When we believe God, amazing things begin to break out. Big things begin to break out. We see the impossible when we choose to trust God and say, God, I trust you. You know, the scripture established in Ephesians 3 verse 20, now unto him that is able to do. So God is able to do exceeding abundantly above what we think nor what we ask, according to his power that worketh in us. God is able to do. Our God is able to do exceeding. He's able to do abundantly. He's able to do above what we think nor ask, according to the power that worketh in us. If you're watching this broadcast right now, God wants to multiply what you have. He wants to use what you have for your glory, for your favor, for your increase. Don't doubt what you have. Don't disvalue what you have. Don't despise what you have. Don't say it's not enough. When faith is in operation, miracles happen. When faith is in operation, miracles happen. And the Holy Ghost will have me say this to you right now. Can you trust me with your future? Can you trust me with your dream? Can you trust me with your destiny? Can you believe me to make a way for you right now? Can you trust me to change your situation? There is someone watching. You've asked this question. What is this among many? What is this among many? What can this bring out? What can this produce? What will this $5 do? What will this $1,000 do? What will this $5,000 do, comparing the depth of a million dollars? What will this do? What will I be able to do? Maybe you heard a doctor's report and the doctor said, your womb cannot receive seed. What do I do? Maybe you heard a doctor's report that this situation has no cure. He trusts us to trust him with what he has given to us. Whatever God has given to you, that is available to you right now, he can multiply it. So when we walk by faith, miracles happen. Great miracles, great healing, great result. So we are going to go by God's report. And this is how we're going to change the situation, because we have made the report of God the foundation for our thinking, the foundation for our expectation. We are going to make God's report our foundation. We're not going to be carried away by the things happening around us or by the situation around us. We're going to say, Lord, I trust you. I trust you with my future. I trust you with my dream. I trust you with my calling. I trust you with everything I can ever dream about. You're watching this broadcast today. The Holy Ghost will have me say this to you. This season, trust him and expect the miracles to happen. If you're watching this broadcast and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray that prayer with us, it means you're born again and the Holy Ghost is going to lead you from this day forward and you will not remain the same. I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teachings on YouTube. When you subscribe to our YouTube channel, your life will not remain the same. So we encourage you also to keep watching finishworktv.com. It's a ministry on the cutting edge, helping people around the world to receive the engrafted word of God. You can get my new book on Amazon.com. 40 things you need to know about your future is available on Amazon.com by Faithman Ogboada. 40 things you need to know about your future. And also, you can consider partnering with this ministry, because through partnership, we consistently take this message of faith to many people around the world. But you can partner with us by going to finishworktv.com/giving, and you'll be able to do whatever the Holy Ghost will lead you to do. Thank you for being part of this broadcast. Until I come your way soon, don't forget this. There is greatness in you, and Jesus is coming soon.